In this video, we'll see how to create a quick sales funnel. And so to do that, we'll go to Create Funnel. And I can just call this, my quick sales funnel, or whatever you want to call it. Of course, usually it would be something that would be specific to what you're selling. And remember that the name that you give your funnel is associated with a list in your account that people are added to whenever they complete this purchase within this quick sales funnel. So you can keep that in mind as well whenever you're choosing the name for your funnel. So I'm going to choose to sell a product, and I'll choose the quick sales funnel. So this is a great method to use if you actually maybe, let's say, have an audience or you have a particular product that you think people would be ready to buy without maybe kind of that nurturing process, because that's a bit of the difference between the full sales funnel and the quick sales funnel. The full sales funnel starts with actually kind of a sign up page with maybe a free lead magnet or promoting your mailing list. They're nurtured with some autoresponders, one or two, or however many you want. And then a little bit later on, they can actually go to your sales page and see your offers and what you're actually trying to sell. But if you kind of maybe have an audience or a type of product that's like ready to buy, and you want your funnel to just start at a page where people can actually view your product and purchase and then be added to your list, a quick sales funnel is great for that. So you just need to let us know what you want to sell. And so you would be choosing from any stores that you have created in your GetResponse account. If you don't have any stores just yet, you would be prompted to create a store. And you can create your own GetResponse store. You don't necessarily need an e-commerce platform to be able to start selling your products online. Of course, if you already do have an account with one of the platforms you see here, you can very easily integrate that account and be able to import the products that you have listed within, let's say, your Etsy account into your GetResponse account, so you could then actually use GetResponse to promote those products within your marketing assets. If you would easily log into Etsy or Stripe or Shopify. If you're using one of these, you could then populate the products you have in that e-commerce platform into your, GetResponse store. Into your store within GetResponse, or create a GetResponse store, which is one, again, you would just create right now. I could just call this, let's say, what am I wanting to sell? Let's just say I'm wanting to sell, an ebook. So I could create my store that's just called ebooks. And then I would need to add a product to my store. And so you can see this would be like a downloadable file, like an ebook. So this would be just called, Abby's ebook, let's just say, and get this, exclusive ebook and learn everything there is to know. Because I know everything, just kidding. And so it would be, let's say, $50, $100, $5, $1, whatever it should be, $1,500. And then you just need to add an image for the product so that someone would actually, be able to see and associate. Like, for example, this could be a cover photo, of your ebook, the design of the cover. And so you could design something like that, use a picture of yourself, whatever it is. You can choose from the files and images you already have inside of your GetResponse account that you've already uploaded to use, in your messages or your landing pages. You can also use, search within a Shutterstock as well. You've got access to 5,000 free images. And so you could also use those as well if you wanted to, as, a method to use that. I'm just going to use an image that I have here. It's not the most beautiful, but it's just a quick example, just something I have handy. And then you would need to actually upload the product file. So this is, like a Word doc, a PDF probably, most commonly. You would just need to go ahead and select the file here. It's going to upload it for me. And then you can choose if you actually want to copy buyers to a particular list. And so, like I mentioned previously, the name that you gave your funnel, contacts will automatically be added to that list, your customers, whenever they complete this purchase and buy this ebook. But if you wanted them to additionally be copied to another list in your account, you could certainly do that as well. So this is just an option that you have, right here as well. And if you wanted to add them to an autoresponder cycle within that list, whatever it is you want to do. So I can click Save now, and it's going to go ahead and load this product. And now one final step here is I just need to choose how to process payments. So how do I, how are people going to be able to purchase this ebook of mine? So I can use Stripe, PayPal, whichever account you have, you can choose that here. I'll use PayPal for this example. And now I just need to create the sales page. So the page that I'm actually going to be using to promote my ebook and hope people buy. And so you can browse all the sales pages and templates. You can build from scratch as well if you wanted to. There's a start from scratch a template there, or you can browse along through the categories. For example, there's a category dedicated to, you know, ebooks and downloads. And so I'll just choose this template. So, you know, ebook, just a name for yourself for right now. And then it's going to open your landing page editor so you can customize the sales page. And so here is going to be, you know, the way, the place that you're going to be customizing everything on this page to kind of match, you know, your brand or your offer. You know, you can upload a new logo. If you, you know, again, had a cover image for the ebook you're promoting, you could just add that here. You know, add the title of your ebook. This is, you know, a good place for a video. If maybe there was a video of yourself talking about, you know, why people should, you know, purchase this ebook, you can do that. Or of course you can delete these things, delete entire sections if you don't think, you know, you need them. You know, totally customize, you know, why people should get this, all of the text, the colors, all of this. But the template's just set up, and you know, in a good way for, you know, good design elements that are, you know, really proven to convert well. And then here is this product box that is going to be automatically created for you based on all the information we put into our product when we're setting up our funnel. And so again, we can delete things like this. Some things were just, you know, created as part of the template, but if you don't need it anymore, you know, that's completely fine. And so you can as well edit things like the, you know, color and font of the, you know, product name, description, things like this. But you can't, for example, change the price here. That's going to be as you set it up initially. You know, you can change the button, color, the text, and you don't actually have to hyperlink the button to make sure that people go to the right place to buy. When they're ready to buy and they would click, for example, here, I want it, they would automatically then go to your order form where they can input their payment details. So this is a very important step as well. So make sure that you customize this, get it looking just exactly how you want it. You know, if you wanted to add an additional product box, you can just go ahead, you know, and drag and drop an additional one right here. So this is going to be the icon that refers to the products. So we could drag it right here, for example. You can see there's yet another product box right here. If you wanted to add some additional products to this, you know, page, maybe you actually decided you want to sell something else on this page and not just this ebook, or you have another ebook, you would just click right here and you can see this option to add and remove products. And you could add an additional product if you wanted. If you decided there's another, you know, checklist or something else you wanted to promote here, you could do that right here. So once we feel that we've got this all customized and good to go, whenever someone actually clicks, you know, buy now, they would go to this order form, which then yet again you can customize. And so you can choose exactly which fields you want to actually have included within this kind of order form. But we do require the email address for sure, and then also this product information. So it actually lists your product and the price and the button. But the rest of it is up to you if this is something you actually need when people are purchasing your product. And as you can see here, we don't actually have a credit card area, because with PayPal, this is who we chose as our payment processor, people would be purchasing via PayPal or through PayPal. So either their PayPal account, or then, as you know, if you're using PayPal, you also have the option to pay with a credit card, you know, within PayPal. So that's why you don't see something like that here, and you don't have to add it because you've chosen PayPal as the processor for this particular funnel. And so you can choose, you know, and edit which exact fields are included. If you don't want all of these fields, don't need it, you can totally remove them as well. You know, you've got full options here to customize that. But you do have to make sure the button stays, the product actually stays, and the email address, because you need to add them to your account. But then it's good to, you know, recap what's included in their order, some testimonials, things like this. So once you've got this customized, we can go to the next step. And we just need to configure this, the settings here. So the SEO settings, you know, the meta title and description are important as well. So you can just see some additional information about that here. You know, Abby's exclusive ebook. You know, get it now. Of course, if I was publishing this for real, I would spend a bit more time to do a bit of research to think about, you know, what's performing well. What are some, you know, maybe a couple of keywords that are going to match well about, you know, what it is I'm promoting exactly. But we can move on here. And then we need to set up the page URL. So, you know, the actual URL that I would then be sharing in promoting on social media, you know, with any advertising that I'm working on. So this is an important step, of course. So if you do have your own domain and you want to assign, you know, this page content to your domain, you'd be able to do that right here. You can see some instructions for how to actually assign and edit your DNS settings, so you could actually assign your own domain or subdomain to this landing page. So you'll see that information here. You know, so Abby's ebook. I'm just going to do that for this example here with the, you know, a GetResponse provided domain. So let's say this is good to go, and I click publish. This is a very big part, of course, of my quick sales funnel. This is the sales page. And so you can also see here, this is going to be the URL now that I would be using to promote, you know, my products, my offers. And then we'll be tracking how many, you know, visitors you get to that page, how many visitors you actually get to your order form, and abandonment rate. So people make it to the order form, but they don't purchase. And then that would be triggering automatically an abandoned order email. So if within 30 minutes someone makes it to this order form but do not complete a purchase, automatically we would be sending an abandoned order email to try and get them back to the order form and complete their purchase. And you can preview what that looks like right here, this abandoned order email. And if you wanted to edit that, you can just hover right here on these three dots here and choose to edit the email, so you can edit, you know, how that would actually be looking if it's going to be sending, you know, this abandoned order email. And then all that's left is to actually, you know, just confirm their order. So you want to just set up the page that someone will see after they successfully complete their purchase. So after, you know, they've made the purchase through PayPal, it's good to go. We just need to set up the page that they would see after that. And so it automatically brings me to kind of a corresponding a thank you page or confirmation page that matches the template I already chose. So I can just give this a name for myself for right now. And then again, just customize this, you know, with my own logo if I want to, you know, customize this, of course, change the text for what, you know, it needs to say. And then this would be actually automatically pre-filled with what someone purchased. So this is not going to be present whenever someone actually makes it to this page. So we'll automatically populate the product box here, and then the button, well, there'll be a button on the product box that has the link to download this ebook. So that's why you remember we uploaded the file. Whenever we were adding this ebook as a product, we had to upload the ebook file. That would be available as a link in a button here on this page. And so that's going to be automatically done for you. And then you can just, you know, again, recap any information that they should know, you know, any contact information, any other information you want them to have. You'll be able to do that on this page. But automatically, we will make the ebook in this example available to download within a button on this page. So we can go to the next step. Again, you can configure the page settings, your SEO settings, title and description, and then automatically the URL is set up for us based on, you know, the domain and subdomain that we set up in the first step for that sales page. And so this is going to be automatically set up for us. And we click publish. And then again, we can see that our funnel is good to go, and we can, you know, start promoting it with our social ads creator if we want. So if you haven't downloaded this free app that you have access to within GetResponse, you can go ahead and get a download link sent to you. And so this is, you know, all you need to do to start, you know, promoting this, you know, ebook, let's say that you're wanting to sell, and then be able to see right here within your funnel how much money you're earning, you know, what's your ROI, and be able to see, you know, total page views, how many new contacts you have, how many customers, you know, and your overall success. And so then people will just be able to, you know, visit this URL and be able to actually purchase this ebook that I have. And I can start earning some money by selling my ebook. So that's great.